Take yourself back in time for a moment to the days when a parade of horses, wagons, clowns, and bands meant only one thing. The circus was coming. Since the early 1800s, the circus has traveled from town to town, village to village, bringing a smile to the faces of young and old alike. Well, every July, the tradition continues. Like their predecessors, the dedicated people of Circus World Museum treat the residents and visitors of Wisconsin to the largest history-based event in North America, the Great Circus Parade.
But before we get too engrossed in the majesty of the parade, how do all these historic wagons get from Baraboo to downtown Milwaukee? Just like they did over a century ago, this parade travels by train. Each of the 75 wagons is carefully loaded onto one of the 18 vintage rail flat cars, the same way in the days of old, with a little horsepower. Even this attracts a huge audience. The entertainment begins shortly after the train departs. This three-day, 400-mile journey stretches through the pastoral beauty of Wisconsin. Weaving its way through the many towns of central and southern Wisconsin, thousands of spectators have the opportunity to witness these exquisite wagons.
I love seeing the countryside, and I think just being on a train, you know, you don't have that many opportunities to ride on a train anymore. It's beautiful.
The people, the crowds, the excitement of being on the circus train, the circus parade, the train, the whole event is really terrific for Wisconsin. It brings a lot of people here, and I think we're fortunate to have this kind of an event that we can participate in.
Very good. Good morning.
Finally, the train reaches its destination. For the next 5 days, Circus World calls Milwaukee's Veterans Park home. The lakefront comes alive with exotic animal rides, circus wagon displays, clown shows, a petting menagerie, band organ concerts, a grand carousel, and of course, live circus performances. This excitement lasts up until the day of the parade.
Finally, the day thousands, make that nearly a million, people have anticipated. Early Sunday morning, preparations are underway.
I think we'll take this candy out.
Costumes are retouched and handed out. Clowns discuss their funniest routines. And the animals are given a final sprucing up. Just as the participants prepare for the grand procession, so do the onlookers. Arriving hours, even days early, hundreds of thousands of spectators eagerly await the pageantry.
It's unusual. People get freaked out. They're not sure exactly why we're here. We get a lot of people going by and saying, "Why do you do this?" and some of it's just, you know, because we can. The city lets us sleep out here and camp out and wait for the parade, and we just make a weekend of it.
I like all the noise and all the animals and all the clowns.
And the tradition, I think it's a lot to do with tradition, people. Just, it's a good reason for families to get together.
Oh, it's world renowned, so it's got to attract everybody from worldwide, really. I would think there's people here from all over.
I got involved in this 3 years ago and I'm hooked. It's just nothing like camping in downtown Milwaukee. It's just, don't know what to say. It's great. The people are fun. It's a good family experience. Just looking at the detail in the yard on the wagons is just fantastic, you know. It brings a lot of childhood memories of going to the circus and that kind of thing.
It's time for the most elaborate circusry parade in the world. The 3-mile-long Great Circus Parade brings to life the historical circus street spectacles of long ago. The parade features more than 100 units comprised of 2,000 costumed participants, 1,000 musicians, 100 clowns, 700 horses, and 75 historic circus wagons from the unequaled collection of Circus World Museum.
Thank you.
Whether you're a child in awe of the spectacle that is the parade, an adult intrigued by the history of the circus, or a kid at heart caught up in the nostalgia of simpler times. Take away the modern skyline and you feel like you are in a bygone era.
Circus World Museum is located in Baraboo, Wisconsin, just 2 hours from Milwaukee, about an hour from Madison, 3 hours from Chicago, 4 hours from the Twin Cities, and just moments away from Wisconsin Dells.
The connection between Circus World and the Baraboo area is a very deep one.
In fact, Baraboo is the birthplace of perhaps the most famous family in circus history.
More than a century ago, Wisconsin became known as the mother of circuses. Some 100 traveling shows either wintered in Wisconsin or called it home. But it was five brothers from Baraboo who made the greatest impact. Founded in 1884, Ringling Brothers Circus grew into the largest circus in the world. In fact, at one time, the Ringlings managed and maintained the three largest circuses in the United States.
On the banks of the Baraboo River, where the Ringling Brothers Circus had wintered for 34 years, stands a National Historic Landmark, Circus World Museum, dedicated to collecting, preserving, and interpreting artifacts relating to the history of the American circus. The museum was opened to the public on July 1st, 1959. From that point on, families have been able to enjoy the attractions and activities Circus World has to offer. They come back year after year to share in the fun and excitement that is the circus.
The museum houses numerous treasures of the Big Top's past, including the posters that once announced the coming of the circus.
The Trumpets of Paper exhibit is a means to share with the public just a small fraction of the thousands of posters that are at Circus World Museum. This particular exhibit includes about 70 different examples that range in age from 1836 on upwards to 1970. It's an attempt to show the broad diversity of circus posters, the different subject matters that were contained within them, the differences between American and European circus posters, and also the simple progression of poster design from the 1830s on upward to modern times. There's some wonderful examples here of the larger posters, sheets that measure almost upwards of 10 feet by 60 feet wide. It's a great example of the many different ways in which a circus enthused the local people about coming to the show when it visited their community.
Posters are among the more artistic pieces the museum showcases. And then there are the wagons.
At the C.P. Fox Wagon Restoration Center, highly skilled craftsmen work diligently to restore the artistic brilliance that first brought these wagons to life. Circus World restores 5 to 6 wagons each year. Down to the smallest detail, each wagon will soon be as vibrant and magnificent as it was in its heyday. The restoration process is painstaking. Taking measurements from decaying parts to manufacture new ones, or fabricating missing parts from historical pictures and documents. The tools needed to accomplish such tasks are much more than chisels, saws, and paint. There's a great deal of pride that goes into each and every wagon.
I just think it's great that there's a place in this country that, or in this world, that you can take the history and bring it back to life like we do here. That's where I get my enjoyment, is bringing these in here and restoring them and making them look like they did at a certain era in history. I think it's great. I just want to emphasize that the guys I got working for me in the shop, that I'm grateful for them, because they're all jacks of all trades. They can work carvings, paint, and we need that here at Circus World Museum. Not just one person can do all this. It's a shop effort.
All this effort so these wagons can once again fulfill their mission, to entertain the people who come to the museum and venture to Milwaukee to watch the great circus parade every year.
The Robert L. Parkinson Library and Research Center is the world's largest facility for research and documentation of circus history.
It's a publicly accessible facility where they can actually look at the materials that were created by circuses up to 200 years ago. We have things like circus contracts and legal documents, correspondence, photography, even sound recordings that they can go back and actually relive part of circus history.
Circus World truly has a lot to offer its visitors year-round. Whether you're visiting the museum, the restoration center, or the Library and Research Center, there's enough history to be explored even before entering the Big Top.
At Circus World, you don't just get a fascinating look at circus history, you also get top-notch entertainment all day long.
The circus animals that greet circus goers as they arrive at the Big Top are just part of that fun. Take a look.
All sorts of animals are waiting to welcome you and to relieve you of any carrots or other food you might have. To see all these animals in one place, you could either visit a zoo or go to a circus. But Circus World may be the only place to get this close to the action. Kids, and kids at heart, are more than welcome to feed and pet the wide variety of domestic and exotic animals found in the menagerie.
Every day you can see these enormous elephants perform under the Big Top. But wouldn't it be fun to be able to hop on board and take one for a ride? Well, at Circus World, you can do just that. It's more than just enjoying the ride, though. You can discover all sorts of interesting things about these magnificent animals, like where they're from, how they're trained, and even what they eat every day. Trainers are around to answer any question you may have.
Elephants are really capable of doing everything that they do. The problem is communication, as far as trying to get the elephant to understand your language to them, which is, you know, strange. So just as far as repeating it over and over again, so the elephant understands what you're trying to get it to do. As far as like laying down, you know, it's just hard to go up to an elephant, say lay down, without the elephant knowing what you want. But once they learn by just repeating it over and over again that you're saying lay down, then the elephant will automatically lay down. So it's just a matter of repeating over and over again.
Why do some camels have one hump and others have two? That's a question I even would need help with. But I know where to go for the answer. The camel classroom.
This is the dromedary?
This is the dromedary.
And the other one, the two hump is the Bactrian.
Bactrian, right. Now people do breed hybrids also between the two.
Really?
It's a very tall camel, taller than either breed. And it does have one hump. It's a very tall hump. It's a little bit different looking.
Getting close to these desert wanderers is just another daily experience featured at Circus World.
Well, the camel is very, very unique. They actually do have a long history on circuses, and they're just different than a lot of, you know, they were one of the first exotic animals that the circus actually brought to town before elephants, and they're just unique. They move a little bit different than most animals, and obviously their hump, and they're just very pretty. They all have their own personalities, so they're very fun to work with.
The animal attractions are just a few of the many daily exhibits Circus World offers. If you're ready for some truly stupendous performances, check out one of the exhilarating live acts. The Razzle Dazzle Review provides nonstop thrills with a variety of talent that truly enjoys showing off. You'll experience baffling magic and illusions. Classic comedy routines. And amazing acrobatic artistry.
Circus World is chock full of breathtaking family entertainment all day long.
During the summer months, you can see some of the finest circus performers from around the world amaze you with their unique talents.
Ladies and gentlemen, children of all...
The famous words that announce the Big Top Show is about to begin. There's no need to wait for the circus to make a trip to your town when you can enjoy all of the thrills every day at Circus World. Admire the courage of the animal tamers. Gasp at the death-defying feats of the acrobats, or just flat-out laugh at the antics of the clowns. Performers from all over the world come to Baraboo year after year to showcase their unique talents. And the good news is, the show changes every summer, So return trips to Circus World will be anything but predictable.
During a run on the bank, Otto Ringling walked through the doors carrying several sacks full of cash. This is for
what would the circus be without the side-splitting comedy of the clowns? Well, for one thing, it would be a lot less funny. You can learn a lot about these performers and even have the opportunity to partake in the fun yourself by being transformed into an authentic clown, complete with makeup and funny shoes. I got my own chance to hang out with Greg and Karen DeSantos, a husband and wife clown team who love to spend their summers playing to the crowds here at Circus World Museum. All right, howdy, Greg and Karen.
Hi, Stephanie.
Hello.
So the clowning process is beginning. What is this stuff on your that you're putting on?
Zinc oxide. It's called Clown White, and it's the basis of all clown makeup. In the old days, the clowns used to have to make this with Crisco shortening and zinc oxide in a bucket.
You're kidding.
No, that's how they did it. And now we're lucky enough to be able to buy it.
Any store in Manhattan.
Well, you two look fabulous in it. May I just say that for the record?
Thank you.
How did you two become clowns? I mean, people grow up and they say, I want to be a teacher, I want to be an accountant, and you said, I want to be a clown.
I think you're born a clown. I don't think you can become a clown. I think you got to have your funny bone in the right place. I think you can train and do it professionally. But ultimately, I think you really are truly born a clown.
Now, I don't know, though. Did we all say, did you wake up one morning when you were 12 and go, today I'll be a clown? I don't know. I don't remember that day. Maybe I did.
I did.
You did?
Now, somebody told me that you two went to an actual clown college.
Mm-hmm.
Now, is this for real, or is it actually a clown college?
This is an actual clown college. It was run by the Ringling Brothers and Barnum Bailey Circus. That was the only way you could get on the circus, the Ringling Circus, was to go to their clown school. And we both attended it. I went in 1985, and Karen went in 1993.
Because you're so much older.
Is this like a 4-year college, a 1-year college, a 3-month?
Hey, this is, get a load of this, 8 weeks.
All right. We got some smart clowns here.
Yeah, that's all we need.
Camp for the circus.
All right, what goes on? What in the world happens at clown college?
It's pretty intense.
You go about 6 days a week. You work from about 8 in the morning to about 10 at night. They teach you everything you need to know about being a circus clown, basically. How to apply makeup, the different kinds of clowns. There's 3 styles of clowns, the white face clown, the Auguste clown, and the character clown. You choose which one you're going to be. As you develop your clown character, your personality, you learn physical skills like how to ride a unicycle, how to walk stilts, how to fall down and do acrobatics, and how to write clown routines, and how to throw pies, and how to catch pies, and how to spit water, and anything you possibly
anything you do with clowning, or even circus for that matter. It's not just about clowning, it's anything. Acrobatics was amazing. I was like, why do we need to learn this? But it's part of the whole circus clowning. It's circus clowning that they're teaching you, not how to do a birthday party, not how to blow up balloons.
Right.
You don't learn that. It's all very physical work.
What drew you to this? I mean, why do you love performing here at Circus World?
We decided that we wanted to really focus on working as a team a clown team, which is not that common anymore in the circus. There aren't that many partners, you know.
Right.
And being husband and wife, it was just a natural thing.
And we have such great audience participation and interaction with it. They, you know, the audiences here are just super.
They're great. Are there any facts, any clown facts, that you could share with our audience that might surprise them about clowning?
No clown would ever copy another clown's face. Your right. face is unique. There are no two clown faces in the world that are exactly alike. You have to change your makeup. You cannot, when you're designing this at Clown College, you'll look at pictures like we have here on the walls, and you'll look at all these clowns and you'll see you can't copy. You might like the style, but you can't copy it. So your face is unique. It's your fingerprints. It's your calling card almost. This is what people will remember you by. Not always your name, not always your billing, but they're going to remember, oh, that's the clown that was at Circus World.
Now, aside from, you know, the accolades you get and, you know, that people are responding to you as clowns, what is it that you yourselves get from being a clown? What's the gratification?
I think, well, for me personally, I think it's the fact that I got to do something I always wanted to grow up and do. It's like I have a lot of friends from school, at high school and in grade school, that like, they, when I come home and visit, they're like, you know what, we're an accountant, we're this, we're that, but you actually got to run away and join the circus.
Yeah, that's
so that's
cool.
Like the cool thing, is that I can look back and say, you know, I really went and did this. It wasn't an easy decision at the time because, and sometimes it isn't an easy decision even
right.
now, because it is a difficult lifestyle at times. We try to make it as normal as possible for our daughter and our family, but you know, this is just so normal you can get when your parents are clowning.
Wait a minute, the Wait. Nose is on.
The yeah. nose is on.
Now, oh, you didn't even see that. I'll show you mine.
How does that stay on?
Well, usually we try staples, and that was good once.
Okay,
now, these are great. I'm telling you, clowning has come a long way. Sure.
Yeah.
Clowning has come a long way. Touch
They're
my
very
nose.
Soft.
It is soft.
It's very soft. There's a clown out there who decided to get off the road and find a second career, and what he does is he makes these for clowns.
Yep.
It's a former clown, a Ringling Brothers clown, who does this, and they're made out of foam rubber.
It's
now,
a project
for $10, you could buy these.
In any last, shape, and
any
color,
yeah, he
size.
Can, he'll tint them whatever color you want, whatever shape.
Glue to
yep.
keep those
yeah.
on?
Yeah, we do a, some clowns use spirit gum, other clowns, we use, it's called Skin Bond, it's a medical adhesive.
Okay.
So it's much stronger. So and then we, since we sweat a lot, we work outdoors a lot.
So you put just a little
yep.
bit on the
just
inside.
I just paint it on right in the little lip, and you can reuse it. That's why it looks a little scungy, because I've been wearing it a couple of weeks now.
Months.
Now our clown nose is expensive.
No, about
$10. What are these? $10?
Yeah. $10 a nose.
So then you just
usually because you're like one or
let
two
it tack up a little bit. You got to make sure I have to wipe all the makeup off my nose and powder. And then I place it on.
And you can really breathe.
Yep.
Totally. Yeah, you know.
And you don't even feel it. That's the nice thing about these noses.
I will
you don't
wear
even,
this all day. This will stay on until 5 o'clock tonight.
Are you kidding me?
I don't even think about it.
You don't even think about
the
it.
The only time you really notice it is if you have a head cold.
What if you have to sneeze?
And I have allergies.
She has allergies.
So I'm constantly, this is me. I'll lift it up and then wipe my nose and then put it back down.
You know, it looks so easy. It looks so easy when you see a clown. You never think of it.
What we'd like to do now is make you into a good-looking clown. What do you think?
Well, you know what? I think that I,
We only need
There's a always
I
time!
Know.
Oh.
Well, there you have it. All I need now is my own clown name. And maybe a little more practice.
While Steph was clowning around, I got a lesson from T.J. Howell on how to do what he does every day, juggle.
One, two, three, and stop.
That's simple. Always, I can count.
Always underneath. Get them up in
right
the air.
Right hand up first.
Yes, sir.
Left
one,
hand,
two,
right
three.
Hand.
Ooh,
whoop.
Almost.
That was off.
Almost.
You know what's tough is throwing with the left hand. You want to throw over this way.
Yeah, that's your odd hand there.
Yeah.
So you're right-handed. Up, under, under.
Yeah. Up, up, up.
Oh, he scores! He scores!
Yeah, but that wasn't real high, though.
Yeah,
I'm not the only one to get the inside scoop on juggling from a true professional. You can juggle, or at least that's the goal, when you try your hand at this circus talent.
Whether you come to Circus World to become a clown, try to juggle, explore the history of the Big Top, or just enjoy the circus itself, you won't go away unfulfilled. There's definitely something for everybody.
To begin planning your trip to Wisconsin's national treasure, visit CircusWorldMuseum.com. Or to get even more information about all the fun-filled things to do at Circus World, call toll-free 866-693-1500.